God is good
all the time.
Oh, praise the Lord, my friend. Whether you like it or not, God is still good. Even if you did not eat today, God is still good. Oh, my goodness. I want to welcome you all. For those who are watching online, we want to welcome you as well. We are so happy to have you connected this evening. The friends who are here in person, we are so excited. If this is your first time to be here with us, we love you and we have extra welcome. And by the way, for those who are here for the first time, you don't have to, when we are done, please don't go. We have a gift for you. Amen? Yes, we have a gift for you. You just take it. This is just a good gift. I believe that you're going to love it. My name is Eric. I'm the pastor at Mount Hope. And we are going to begin with an opening prayer from our brother Jacob.
Please pray with me. Lord God, we thank you for another Christmas season. We thank you that you brought us through another year. It hasn't been easy for all of us, Lord. It hasn't been easy for many. We just thank you that you brought us this far. We ask that you help us through this service, but really through every day, through the daily service of our walk with you, to continue to bring us closer to you, Lord God. Help bring peace to our hearts. Father God, we're asking during this season of hope and peace for divine hope, Lord, and divine peace. We thank you for everything, Lord God, and we just ask a blessing upon each household represented here. We ask a blessing on each child, even the children who can't be here tonight. We just ask that you help us to get everything out of this. Let us pray service that we can. We just thank you for these and all things. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. All right. We're going to start this service off musically with a number from my brother Mike. like to... Oh, go ahead, Pastor Nancy. I'm sorry, I was going to invite the kids up, but maybe I'm jumping the gun just a little bit. All right, I'd like to invite the children up and my beautiful wife, Jessica, the narrator.
All right, children, if you guys want to head to your spots, just like we practiced. The angel Gabriel was sent to Mary. He had good news to share. "Do not be afraid," said Gabriel. "God loves you." He told Mary she would have a baby. The baby would be God's son. The angel said, "You will name him Jesus." Mary and Joseph were going to make a trip to Bethlehem. Mary rode on a donkey. When they got to Bethlehem, there were people and donkeys everywhere. All of the houses were full. There was no place to sleep. Finally, they found an animal stable. Mary and Joseph decided to stay in the stable. That night, something wonderful happened. The baby Jesus was born. Mary and Joseph wrapped him so that he would stay warm. They made a bed for him in the manger. The animals were the first to see the newborn baby. In a nearby field, shepherds were watching over their sheep. An angel appeared to them. The angel told the shepherds the good news of Jesus' birth. The angel said to the shepherds, "Do not be afraid. I am bringing you happy news for all people. Today in Bethlehem, God's son was born. You can go see him." The angel told the shepherds where they would find the baby. Then many angels came from heaven. They began praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest and peace on earth." The shepherds left their flocks and hurried to Bethlehem. They saw a star over the town. Soon the shepherds saw the stable. There the shepherds found the newborn baby Jesus. The shepherds told everyone what happened on that special night. Jesus, we are here. Jesus, we are here. Jesus, we are here. We are here for you. Jesus, we are here. Jesus, we are here. Jesus, we are here. We are here for you. Thank you.
That was excellent. You know, practice was minimal, but they all came together at the last minute, and they did it well with only, two practices, right? So I'd like to share with you our scripture for this evening, and I also have chili results of our winner, but should we save that for the end?
Yes.
Yeah? Okay, we'll do that at the end. It's really cool how it turned out. So our scripture for this event tonight is from Matthew 5, 14 through 16. Hear the words that Jesus said. You are the light of the world. A city on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on its stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before men, that they may see your good deeds and praise your Father in heaven. Good words for us tonight. Have you ever thought about yourself being a light that shines brightly in the world? Have you thought about that? Have you thought about God looking down on the earth and seeing all the people in all the churches shining brightly, glowing, and it goes back up to God? There's a lot of darkness in the world too, but the church is a place of light and a place that glows with Holy Spirit glowing. This evening we're going to talk some more about prayer like we did last time with the concept of ACTS, A-C-T-S. The A stands for adoration, we adore God. The C stands for confession, we say sorry, Lord, for our sins. The T is for thanksgiving, that we say thank you, God, for the ways you bless me. And the S is for supplication, which is the prayer request, what we normally think of when we say let's pray, and we say God help with this, 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 and this. So it's all that together. The adoration is the idea of God is holy and we are not. God is great and we are not. God oversees all the universe. He created it all. And he sent his son to live on the earth and to go to the cross and to die and come alive again and return back to heaven and watch down upon his church and all of us and watches for our holy glow that he gives us. So we worship God, we adore God, we praise God. It's what we do on Sunday morning when we come together as the church, or anytime we listen to Christian music and maybe sing it, or we go to Bible study, or we walk through our week going to work, or all the things we do. We worship God through our actions. It's like we're the light of the world, every single one of us. All of you took time to come here on your Wednesday night. You could have picked something else to do, but you came here. So God's seeing your glow right now. And we give all of our praise and worship to God. The C stands for confession. God is God, and we are not. We are people. We are humans. And so God wants us to say, sorry, Lord, for the sins we have done. Confessing our sins, whether we think we've done wrong or not, is not the point. The point is God is holy, he is pure, he is sinless, God is sinless. We are not. We are sinful people in need of a Savior. So we are sinners just because we're humans. Whether we think we did anything wrong today, yesterday, last week, is not the point. The point is we are sinful people in need of a Savior. That's how God set up the system. So we, A, adore God and worship God, and C, we confess our sins to Holy God. And Pastor Eric's going to come and talk to us about the T and about the S. He's on his way. I have a scripture to share, 1 John 1:9. If we confess our sins, God is faithful and just, and will forgive us of our sins and purify us from unrighteousness. If we claim we have not sinned, then we make God out to be a liar. And then his word is not in us because we don't understand what the Bible says. So if we say, Lord, forgive me of my sins, God hears and responds by saying, you are forgiven. It's that easy and that good. Come on up, Pastor Eric.
Thank you, Pastor Nancy. God is good. These are the ways of helping each other to pray. Sometimes we take prayer so hard and say, how am I going to pray? I don't know how to pray. So I believe that the way of bringing the act, the last time we talked about push, the act will help you also to pray. Pastor Nancy talks about the A and the C. We're going to talk about the T, what stand for. T stand for thanksgiving. We are always rushing to ask God, I want. That's, I know, I'm one of them because I've been there too. I learned to stop telling God I want before I say thank you, Jesus. That scripture that reminds us all about the letter T, thanking God. The Bible says in the book of Philippians, chapter 4 and 6 to 7, I love this scripture. They say this, do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition. With thanksgiving, present your request to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your mind in Christ Jesus. Wow. Wow. We are called not only to thank God on Thanksgiving. Where, you know, I understand that Thanksgiving is a big deal where we are living right now. But as a believer, we are called to thank God each and every day. When you wake up in the morning, thank God for the food. Thank God for your friends. Thank God for the opportunity to go to school. Thank God even for your neighbor. Even if you have a troublemaker neighbor, say, God, I thank you, because God knows the reason why the neighbor is there. Amen? Yeah. When you wake up in the morning, you children, say, thank you for friends. We are living in a world where, I'm telling you, there are places where people are looking people need friends. But you do have friends. Thank God for the church. Thank God for Jacob. Thank God for your pastor. Thank God for every single child of God that he has been part of your life. Amen? Thank God even for your friends who just say, good morning today. Thank God. Thank God for your mama in the morning. Thank God for your papa. When you wake up in the morning, children, are you with me? Hey, children, are you listening? Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. When you wake up in the morning, say, God, I thank you for mama. I thank you for papa. I thank you for Christ. Thank you for my teacher. Thank you. Thank God. Thank God even for where we are living, because we have places in this world where people can't even sleep, I'm telling you. People are looking for food. People are looking for clean water. You have clean water in the morning. And that, what if you wake up in the morning, you say, mama, did you say thank you to Jesus because we have got juice in the fridge? Mama, did you say thank you, Jesus, because you have $1 in your bank account? Papa, did you say thank you to Jesus this morning because you can even go to work and come back? Learn to build a spirit up to say thank you, Jesus. Amen? All right, and then another scripture, the same scripture, I love this, 1 Thessalonians 5, 16. It says this, rejoice always, pray continually, give thanks in all situations, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. Friend, as believers, we can even say, God, thank you because you have been with me throughout this time for pandemic. Friend, sometimes I wake up in the morning, I look at myself and say, I'm not perfect compared to those who have lost their beloved one with COVID. When we wake up in the morning, say, God, thank you. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for the breath of life. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for your coming. Because of you, I'm alive. Because of you, I have got friends. Because of you, I can talk. I can have this. I can have that. Amen? All right. And the third one, that's where many Christians love. The S. The S stand with supplication. They're going to put it there. The S stand for supplication. You know, we love to do that. We love to do that. We love to go before God and say, Lord, I need this. We love that. Lord, I'm going through all this. God, and we worship a lovely God. Yes, indeed. He can hear us. But before you get to that, you have to thank him first. Amen. You have to thank him, even if your prayer is not yet answered. Learn to say, God, I thank you because your time is not my time. You have the best time. Thank God. Supplication. The Bible says in the book of Daniel, this is very good. I love this. Daniel chapter 6, verses 11. It says this. Then this man came by agreement and found Daniel. Daniel is one of the prophets in the book of the Old Testament. And those days they were living in Babylon. And they wanted to present their request before God. So the men, they looked for Daniel. They found Daniel. When they met Daniel, they said, Daniel, can we make a petition? Can we make a supplication before your God? because we know your God can do it. And Daniel took it and presented it before God. Friend, don't ever be ashamed to go to your Father. You do have an heavenly Father who is able to hear your prayer. The book of Jeremiah 33, verse 3, this is my 911. Get it also. I'm going to share this with you. Many times when you have a problem, call 911. I have a 911 to God, directly to God like that. Jeremiah 3:3:3. Call unto me, I will hear you, and I will show you things that you have never seen before. That's the moment where you go to God and you present your request. Don't ever be tired and taking your situation before God. I want to encourage somebody here this evening. I don't know what you have been asking to God. I don't know what you have been presenting to God since this year, but up to now, you haven't seen it. But it is a word for you this evening. Keep asking, because the Father say, present your request before me. Sometimes a no is good. Sometimes a wait is good, because God knows better than all of us here. So learn to present your request before God. Don't ever be tired and say, I've been asking God for this. He haven't even given me. Why should I go? It's like going to your daddy or your mom and say, Mommy, I need this. And I need another thing. Oh, my mom, my parent haven't given me that. But learn, I want you to know, before God, all the requests are very good. Keep presenting them to God. If you have been asking for something up to date in 2021, you haven't received them yet, that's good. If you have another one in 2022, you have to go before God and ask him again. Amen? All right. We're going to take this moment and pray together, because we want to put what we have just shared into practice. Amen? And in our church, my brothers and sisters in Christ, we pray in different languages. We pray in Swahili, you pray in French, in English, in Spanish. The good thing is, God hears us at the same time. Amen? Friend, prayer must be a priority in our lives. Prayer. Whatever you're watching, maybe you have taken prayer at the bottom, something you said, I'm going to do it when I feel like. Today, I want to call you to take prayer as a necessity in your life. Not an option that I'll pray when I feel like. It's not about feeling. Prayer is a priority. Friend, why prayer is a priority? Prayer is a sin killer. When you pray, God can kill that sin you are struggling with in your life. That's why many people sometimes they are afraid of praying when they do sin, because they know when they pray, God can kill that sin in our lives. Prayer, my friend, is the power bringer. Prayer, when you pray, it gives you power. I'm telling you, try one day when you are weak. You just said, I'm going to pray to God. God is going to fill you up with that power. Try that. Prayer is a power bringer. Prayer is a Christ revealer. When you pray, God is going to reveal himself through you. God is going to speak to you. God is going to speak to your personal life and personal situation. Prayer is a Christ revealer. Prayer is a problem remover. Do you know that? Prayer is a problem remover. When you pray, my friend, I'm telling you, try this. When you keep praying, some of the problems that are living in your life, prayer is a problem remover. Prayer is a dispute healer. Prayer is a holiness promoter. When you keep on praying, you are going to grow in your Christian life. You are going to grow in your holiness. Keep praying. Prayer is a holiness promoter. Prayer is a victory giver. Those who pray, they are always victorious. I'm always using this with my partner in Christ, Pastor Nancy, and I said, the more you pray, the taller you stand in this world. The more you pray, the taller you stand. Keep praying, my friend, because prayer is a victory giver. When we out, when you come out of prayer, you become more than a supernatural. You become more than a Superman you watch on TV. You become more than that. When you come out of prayer, even the world is being shaken up and somebody's coming. That's what happened with Jesus many times. Whenever he comes from prayer and people were just, oh my goodness, he's coming. Whoever hold, touch his hand, touch his robe, will receive the healing. Why? Because he was coming from prayer. Those who have been in prayer, they are not people that you can play with. So keep on praying, my brothers and sisters. We're going to pray tonight. We're going to pray tonight, my brothers and sisters. Wherever you are, you're going to take this moment and put it this into practice. As we learn today, the Acts, A-C-T-S, adoration, confession, thanksgiving, and supplication. We're going to put this into practice. And when you pray, my friend, I'm inviting you not to use your feelings, use your faith. Amen? I'm going to invite you. If you feel like coming up here, it's okay. If you feel like staying where you are, it's all right. And then what we're going to do, I'm going to invite you to just adore God. I don't want you to thank God, as Pastor Lansing said. I don't want to thank God. Don't say thank you, God, now. Just say, God, I worship you. You are the healer. You are the savior. Name him. I want you to just acknowledge who he is in your life. You are more than anything, God. Without you, I cannot be where I am. I don't want you to start asking God, asking for confession. Not yet. Until you hear me doing this. If I do this, then we move on to another prayer. We go now to confession. Are you with me? Are you with me? We're going to take this moment, my brothers and sisters in Christ. Just go before God. Go before God and begin to adore God. Begin to worship God. Begin to picture God the Creator. Begin to, you know, there was a moment in the Bible where the religious leader asked, who is this? When Jesus was going through Jerusalem. Begin to adore God. Begin to lift up your God. Begin to acknowledge that he's a savior, he's a guider, he's a promoter, he's a blesser, he's a healer. Begin to adore him. Shall we pray in Jesus' name? Let us pray. Let us pray, Father. You can pray loud or silently. Those who are watching online, do the same, brothers and sisters in Christ. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Let us pray. Let us adore God. Precious God, Heavenly Father, holy and living God, we come together in one accord. We worship you. We acknowledge your presence in our lives. You are our Savior. You are our healer. You are our guider. You are our blesser. You are our protector. You are everything in the life of this church. Lord God, we worship you. We acknowledge your presence this evening, God. Holy are you. Thank you, God. We worship you. We worship you. We worship you. We worship you. We lift up your name. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. We worship you for the great thing, God, we have done in the past of this church. We worship you for the thing that, God, you are doing today. We worship you for the thing that, God, you are going to do in 2022. We worship you. Oh, yes, Lord. Oh, yes, Lord. Oh, yes, Lord. Oh, yes, Lord. We are going to move again. Now we are moving from the letter A to the letter C. The letter C talks about confession. Friend, we have sinned against God in so many ways. As a church, we have wronged God. We have done bad things before the Lord. As an individual, you know well, but we do have a God full of mercy. We have a God who loves us so much, and we have a God who loves to see His people coming to Him and say, Father, forgive me. I confess my sins. So I'm inviting you to confess your sins and the sins of the church and the sins of the world. Shall we pray in Jesus' name? Let us pray. Oh God, eternal God, we are here tonight. We acknowledge, oh God, that we are sinners. We have sinned against you, Lord, in so many ways. Through our speech, our desires, our feelings, the way we looked at each other, the way we do things does not please you at all. Father, we pray, God, in Jesus' name. I pray that, God, for mercy. Have mercy on us. Have mercy, God, in Jesus' name. Have mercy upon us in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I pray for confession in Jesus' name. Lord, I confess the sins of the church, the sins, oh God, of the community, the world. Oh God, I confess my personal sins in Jesus' name. Lord, have mercy on me. Have mercy, God, over this church in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we do things, oh God, that's not please you at all. We pray that, God, for forgiveness. Father, we pray for forgiveness. Forgive us. Forgive us. Forgive us. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 We are going to take again this moment. You can stay here. Hallelujah. We are now moving to the letter T. I want you to begin to thank God. I want you to begin to say, God, I thank you. You can even stand up if you are able. You can stand up. Can you stand up, please? Just begin to say, God, I thank you. Hallelujah. Say, God, I thank you for my friends. I thank you for my family. Oh, Lord, in Jesus' name. Father, I thank you for each and every child of yours who are here this evening. I thank you for those who are watching online. I thank you for those, God, who have used, hallelujah, since this church was started. I thank you for all the pastors who have ministered into this church. I thank you for the band's leaders. I thank you for the chancel choir. I thank you for those who got baptized this year in 2021. I thank you, God, for the winter coat that the children receive. Father, I thank you for that ministry of the food. Lord, I thank you in the name of Jesus Christ for today. God, I thank you for the food that we have, for the house that we have, the car we drive. I thank you for friends in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I thank you for Christmas is coming. Lord, I thank you because you are good. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. Father, I thank you for what we don't see. I thank you for what you have already seen. I thank you for what you haven't heard. I thank you for what you have heard in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, I thank you, oh God, even for enemies, those who speak against us. We say thank you because you see them. We say thank you because you know them. Lord, I thank you, God, for those who are get saved today in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, I thank you for your divine protections. Lord, you protect us, Lord, from the things we don't see in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, thank you, Lord. Thank you for this church. Thank you for the next pastors. Thank you, God, in the name of Jesus Christ. I give all the glory because, Father, you have our lives in your hand. In Jesus' name. Thank you for the power of the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus, Joshua HaMashiach. I give all the glory and the blessings unto you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, thank you, God, for those who are part of the ministry. Thank you, God, for those who are thinking of joining. Thank you, God, hallelujah, for those who serve you in different capacity. In the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we give all the praise and honor unto you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. But I thank you for my neighbors. Thank you for my brothers and sisters in Christ in the United States. My brothers and sisters in Christ in Africa, in Europe, everywhere. God, I thank you. Thank you for our neighbors. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We thank you for doctors and nurses. We thank you, God. Hallelujah. We thank you. for the ways that God, you use them powerfully. We thank you for the people who owns companies, oh God, they are hiring people, thought that, Lord, we can have something, Lord. I will thank you, Jesus. Oh, yes, Lord. We thank you for this country. We thank you for people who serve, dear God, to make this country, God, as it is. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. For now, I'm inviting you to present your requests before God. I'm inviting you to present whatever you have in your heart. Friend, we do have a God who can hear. We have a God who can supply. I want you to speak to God. You can sit down if you want. You can kneel or you can stand. Feel free. But I want you to speak to God. Present your vision. I know you have the vision. Hallelujah. I know you have a dream. Oh, yes, Lord. Let us pray. Let us present even our church before God. Yes, Lord. Oh, yes, Lord. Pray with me. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I present Mount Hope before your throne of grace. I pray according to your word. You said it is not by might, by strength, it is by the power of the Holy Spirit. I speak for the power of the Holy Spirit to lead this church in the name of Jesus Christ. Eternal God, we agree together, but your name is greater, your name is power, your name is healer, your name is blesser, your name is guider. We ask your name in the name of Jesus Christ to bless this church, to heal this church, to give this church the power to minister in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray for every child of yours who have come this evening and those who are watching online. You know their need. I present their need before you. In the name of Jesus Christ, receive it. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Father, we pray that for the need of the church. Hallelujah. To become a church, oh Father, as a soul station. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Help our church to become, to be, Father, a soul saving station. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray for our church to be, Father, Lord, hallelujah, a soul saving station. In the name of Jesus Christ, those who come, Father, they will seek for you, they will find you in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, I bless you, hallelujah. We thank you, Jesus. I present prayer requests, Lord, and spoken before you. I pray for those who are sick. I speak for healing in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray that, Lord, for those who are struggling from anything, we pray that, Lord, for your hand to be upon them. Those who are mourning, we pray for comfort in the name of Jesus Christ. Those who are struggling, Father, from anything, that including cancer, we speak for healing in Jesus' name. Those who are struggling with COVID, we pray for healing in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, Father. Father, thank you for hearing us. Thank you. We give all the glory and honor unto you. Because, Father, we believe you receive all the prayers that your children have presented tonight. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. We pray together. And we say, amen. 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 All right. Now I'm going to invite you to stand up so that we're going to sing together. And Jacob is going to sing with us.
All right.
Of my own, I had no right to draw near.
Well, we'd just like to thank you so much for coming out tonight, and I think Pastor Nancy has a few final words for us.
I sure do. I'd like to say thank you to all of you who came, just like Jacob did. This has been so much fun. Isn't this a great way to spend a Wednesday evening? It's just been great. Thank you to all of you who helped. There are some who have been working with me for a few days, and some that came early today, and some that helped during the events in the gym. Wasn't it fun to see Santa Claus and Mrs. Claus? That was just cool. And you got a book, right? Take your book home with you, read it, and a candy cane. And we ate chili. Did you enjoy eating chili?
Yes.
Yes?
Yes.
Mount Hope first ever chili cook-off. I have our winner. I bet you'll be surprised. It was number 18. Yes. Number 18 had 18 votes. How did that happen? But that's our winner, and that's Paula Bernath and her wonderful pot of chili that you all voted for. And it won by a lot. So we say thank you to Paula for making the chili tonight, and we also say thank you to Larry for carrying the pot into the church, because he helped too. All right? Thank you to all of you and all that you have done. I hope you leave here with a little bit better understanding about how to pray, and a little bit better understanding about how what you say to God matters to God. You may not think you're praying very well. You may not think you're talking to God very well. But God wants to hear what you have to say. So keep on talking to God. Prayer is that simple. Keep on talking to God. So thank you to everybody. Thank you to the Lord for being with us today. Be careful when you go home. It started to ice up just a little bit. as the sun went down, so be careful. We want to know that you make it home safely. And there's a little bit more cleaning up to do in the gym. If you'd like to stay and help with that, we'd be grateful. Be blessed by God. Go forth. Don't move yet. I'm not done. Where are you going? I'm almost done. It's like, is that a signal to stop talking or what? Be blessed by God to go through your week this week, loving the Lord and being the bright light that God wants you to be as His church, as His people, as His friends. Let God be your Savior. Go forth in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. 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 All right.